This episode is not sponsored by Yerba Mate's Goyaki, but it should be. Sponsor us. All right, guys, so we're going to do a 10-minute logo design for our friends at Trainly. Before we do that, I need a like, I need a subscribe, and we're going to do something that I don't do often, but because I've been doing this for so long, I believe that I can do this in under 10 minutes. So we're going to create something cool today. You're going to be along with me, and you're going to see exactly what I'm doing. I'm going to walk you guys through it at the same time. So without further ado, let's just go ahead and roll right into it. Hey guys, welcome back to another Adrian Graphics and Marketing video. We're gonna have some fun today. I love to design and today is that day. So you're gonna get to jump onto my computer here with me and watch me create a logo in under 10 minutes. The only reason why I'm able to do this is because I've been doing this for 15 years. So a 10-minute logo takes 15 years of experience for me at least, and I know I'm gonna create something beautiful. So let's just go ahead and jump right in. But first, hit that subscribe button, hit that like button, so you guys can get updated for all my content, tutorials, trainings, mindset, and motivation. So there's gonna be a lot of good stuff here, so you're gonna wanna see everything we got. Make sure you hit that bell once you hit the subscribe button. So let's jump into it. All right, so what I'm gonna do first is I'm gonna create a new canvas. And just like my last project I did, I'm gonna keep the specs the same, 3,000 by 3,000 with two artboards. We're gonna go ahead and hit create. And then what we're gonna do is I'm gonna jump back over here to my Trainly page, and I'm just gonna take the logo right off their website. Keep it very simple. So I have a reference point. I'm gonna paste that in here. I'm gonna hold down shift. I'm gonna make it way bigger. I'm gonna hold down shift, drop it here at the bottom. Now, as you can see, they kind of have a traditional style font. There's no serifs or anything on it. There's these little arms and posts that come out on that. So it's kind of traditional. It looks timeless. It looks like it's been around for a very, very long time. And what we wanna do is we don't wanna go too far away from that, but we wanna create something a lot better. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna create a new text type out here. There we go, and you can see it automatically fills that in. That's something they've been doing lately. Put Trainly in there. You can't even hardly see it because it's so small. We're gonna go ahead and stick that in there, and then we're gonna center it, and then I'm gonna adjust the kerning a little bit. So I'm gonna go to, let's just go to our character real quick here, and if you missed that, I hit Alt and Option for kerning, and you can go left arrow, right arrow, and you can see it in the character here, adjust. So Alt or Option, you go right or left, see, and I'm gonna spread it out just a little bit. I think 120 is about right. I don't know why it did that. And then what we're gonna do is we're gonna pick a font. So I happen to know of a couple fonts that I wanted to use for this project, but I'm not gonna spend a ton of time doing research. What I did want to show you is if I go to Google Images, and let me just pull this up and open here, and I type in train logo. It's always good to do a little bit of research. We can hit images here. We can just look at some ideas, get some inspiration. These are generic, super generic. A lot of these are gonna be very generic logos, nothing really special. Nothing that's really memorable or stands out. I'm not really liking much of this, but this kind of gives me an idea of what other people are doing. This is kind of a cool one just for the simple fact that it's similar colors, and it looks like it's been around for a while, so I think that one's pretty decent. I like this kind of silhouetted one. Looks more logo-like, and we need a logo mark, and then you have this one here that has a lot of detail in it. We're not gonna have that much time today. So now that I kind of have an idea of what I'm going for, I like this concept. I'm gonna go ahead and jump in here and apply some of these ideas and kind of come up with my own. So let me go ahead and make this box smaller. Let's grab this in here. And I'm gonna pick a font that I know is a good font. There we go, Sneaker. And I can do different ones. I think I'm gonna do this one right here. Go Sneakers Pro, right? And I can scoop this down. I'm gonna duplicate it. I'm gonna bring it over here because you're gonna get a 2-for-1 today. You're gonna get two logos. All right, and then I'm gonna take this font, I'm gonna pick one more. I wanna be able to do a variation and give my client some options. So the other one that I was thinking about was Montserrat, and Montserrat has an alternative font that I really like. I think I'm gonna do that bold. There we go, see that? See, kind of a newer age, and it has the same kind of bars and serifs on it, and then you have something a little bit more cutting edge, a little bit new, but I feel like it has kind of a timeless look to it. Looks like it's been around for a long time, and we're gonna stick with those two. So that's gonna be our word mark or our text font that we're using for the moment, and now we're gonna jump into the logo mark. So whether I put this directly above it or off to the left, it doesn't really matter. I just need to get a concept down. So I held shift, I drew a circle. Now what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna flip it over here, and I'm gonna put a stroke on this, and I'm gonna make this stroke about 20 points right there. That's about right. Then I'm gonna duplicate the circle, so I'm gonna click on it, hit Alt or Option. You can see the little other little arrow key shows up with a little white one underneath that. I'm gonna click and drag. There we go, while holding shift. I'm gonna hold shift down. I'm gonna make this thing just a little bit smaller, right around there. A little bit more. Whoops, hold on, let's grab that right there. a little bit more. There we go. Right around there. Okay. Then we're going to go ahead and make it simple. We're going to hit align. We're going to center align, left align, up and down align. So everything is centered. Now I'm going to go in and I'm going to actually, let me do this first. I'm going to go in and I'm going to take this one. And I'm going to copy it again. I'm going to drag it down. And I'm going to get rid of all of the fills. There's not going to be any fills, no stroke fill or anything like that. Then I'm going to go in here to transform, make it just a hair smaller. There we go. And now I'm going to use my text tool. You can see since I have no fill, I'm going to hold down Alt or Option. Bam. And then I'm going to hold down Shift. And then right there below the delete button on my keyboard is that straight line. I'm going to make some train tracks. This is the idea that I had come to my mind here. Let me get that in there. There we go. Some train tracks. Right now what I'll do is this is too big, so I'll make it smaller. Probably go around 140. There we go. I think that's about right. That looks like train tracks. But the problem is those train tracks are spread way too close. So I want to spread them out a little bit. There we go. Maybe like that. And then I can even add one more line probably. There we go. It looks nice and even. So now I got some train tracks there. That looks pretty cool. What I'm going to do is I'm going to copy this. I'm going to bring this over here. Hold Alt or Option. Drag this baby over here. Boom. Okay. We're going to grab that. Now I'm going to take this font and I want to use the same T that I used inside of there. And I'm going to bring that, I'm going to bring that in there. And then I'm going to go back to my cursor tool and I'm going to hit Shift Command or Control O and it's going to outline it. Then I'm going to drag this up here to the top. I want to put it right in the center. I'll transform it a little bit, make it a little bit bigger so it's a little bit more prominent. There we go. I got my T inside of there. And then I'll do the same thing over here on this one. Drag this down, remove the other letters, hit Shift Command or Shift Control O. It'll outline it. I'm going to do the same thing, drag it up into the middle. Right there, center, hit the transform tool, boom, 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 up four. I'm holding down shift while I do that. And now you can see I got a cool little concept with the train tracks. Now this looks like a train company. That was the issue that I was finding is that you can't really tell that this is a train company. This gives it a little bit more of that look. What I wanna do now is just add a little bit of color so I can play around with this and have some fun. I can just color swap this and go right here. Boom, there's that. I can hit my cursor tool again, do the same thing on the other one. Add that, boom, now I got those two concepts. I can add some color to the tracks if I want, so I can go right here, hit that, make it blue, boom. So now I have some track colors. It's added a lot of dimension and depth to it, so I think that's pretty cool, or I can keep it black. I think the tracks should stay black, and then maybe Trainly turns blue like this, so now I kind of have this logo standing out, same thing here, I'm gonna do that in blue, adding some color, some depth, some texture to it, and that's what we've done in just a couple minutes here. Now I'm just going to delete this because I'm not going to need this anymore. I'm going to add in my copyright logo because I love adding that in. And we'll change the font to like Arial or something simple. Boom. Go like that. Command O. Grab this, put this up here in the top corner. Hold down shift and make it much smaller. There we go. There we go. We'll bring this in here. Give it more of that official logo look. I feel like that's really important to add into here. I can copy this, drag it over to this one. Do the same thing. Boom. Now we got something that actually looks like a professional logo design. And if we wanted to, we could do some cool and creative things with the time that we have left. We can actually put another background behind this. Here we go. We can put this back here. There we go. I can bring this to the back. Now I can do something like this where I deselect this. In fact, what I did there, I was moving kind of quick. So I highlighted everything. Now I'm gonna hit Command or actually Shift and I'm gonna unselect that circle. And then everything that's inside of here, I just selected. I'm gonna unselect this. So now I'm not doing that one either. I'm probably gonna wanna unselect here. What I'm trying to do here is hit that one. There we go. I'm gonna turn this to white. There we go. And I'm gonna grab this inner line. Where is that at here? Let me hit outlines, Command O. It'll show you your outlines. I'm gonna click this guy right here. Let me select off of this. In fact, what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna outline that. There we go. And then I'm gonna do the same thing here. I'm gonna make this white. I'm gonna grab this one, I'm gonna make this white, boom. Now when I hit Y, Command Y again, there we go. See, and that ended up being a little bit too bold, I think, with these train tracks. I would adjust this if I had just a little bit more time. But as you can see here, we've already kind of got the train track look. I can put this logo in white too if I wanna do a white version. Whoops, that was a stroke. Flip this here, boom. There we go. And you can see here, I can do a couple different versions and obviously I need to align this. So I'm gonna go like this, and like this. Make sure that everything is aligned. If I wanted to make this a little bit bigger, I could. There we go. Or I can make this blue if I really want to. Right here. Boom. So it would actually work. I got to select the right thing there. There we go. See, and so I can add and do some different things, but I feel like this is a better, more relatable logo for Trainly. Gives them a better vision of who they are and people can understand what they do. And just want to keep it super simple for you guys. But this is my 10-minute logo. In fact, I'm going to bring these both down to the center of here. This is my 10-minute logo that I wanted to do for you guys for my friends at Trainly. I will probably touch this thing up a little bit more, spend a couple more minutes, and then I'm going to present this to them and I'll let you know. But I want to know what you liked about this, what you didn't like. I'm open to criticisms, what you would do differently. I just want to hear back from you guys. Hopefully this helped you, and I look forward to seeing you guys on the next video. As always, keep looking up.